in the paper.
Yes. Yay.
All right.
Take care.
All right.
Hey everyone, long time no see. I am so sorry I've been MIA for so long. We pretty much had a disaster here in the house with a busted water pipe, and my living room was non-functional, my kitchen was non-functional, and I was just stressed out. I wanted to start nesting and I couldn't because the bedrooms were a mess, and it's just been whatever. I was in no mood to do any videos, but now thankfully we've got new flooring. I can walk through my living room again. I can sit on my couch. We've painted the walls. Everything is fine. So life is getting back to normal. But I hope y'all got to see the clip from our gender reveal at the beginning of this video. I know the quality is horrible. I'm sorry, but that's all I had to work with. But we are having a baby boy, and we are just so excited, just so happy. We have his name picked out, which is not a very common name, at least down here in the South. Or to me, it's not a very common name. But I think there was one little boy that had that name when I worked at the daycare years ago. And I think when I first joined the YouTube community, one of the moms, I think, named her son this. I don't know. And then his middle name is the same. It's not a very common name that you hear a lot, at least, again, down here in the South. You don't hear it. But we are keeping it off of social media as much as we can because we want something to be a surprise about him. So when he's born, we can announce his name and it's still a surprise. So, but yeah, we're just so excited. As far as like updates and everything, I don't even know where to begin because it's been so long. So I'll just kind of talk about some things that I can remember since my last video. 13 weeks is when I had my gender scan, and that's when we found out that it was a boy. I also had a scan at 16 weeks due to some fluid that was kind of freaking me out. Everything was fine. The baby was fine. I'm fine. But we got to see him again. And then we had a more thorough anatomy scan at 18 weeks. And at 18 weeks, he weighed 9 ounces and was just perfect. Everything about him was perfect. He was stretching and moving, and he's fine. I'm sorry if y'all hear that. That's my husband. I think he's watching some YouTube videos. So, today is December the 4th, and I am 23 weeks and 3 days pregnant, I believe. So I'm approaching 6 months of pregnancy, which blows my mind. It's just so hard to believe that I'm already at this point. I have one more month until I'm in the third trimester, so. It's hard to believe. Let's see. My nausea went away during the 14th week of pregnancy. The last day of my 13th week, I threw my guts up. In fact, it was the day after my gender reveal. I puked all day. I felt horrible. And then the next day, I drank my first cup of coffee since being pregnant. And as soon as I finished the cup, I threw that up as well. So I don't know if I had a touch of a bug or if it was pregnancy related, but, yeah, that was not fun. And since then, I only really get nauseated if I take my prenatal on an empty stomach or just eat something that's not settling good with me, but I really haven't had any bad nausea spells since then. I still gag every once in a while. I gagged yesterday morning while brushing my teeth. That's when I gag. And, you know, I don't really say threw up like I dry heaved, but the stomach acid gross stuff came up. Sorry. That hasn't really happened in a while, but yeah. Let's see. The main symptom that I've been having is really bad sciatica pain. And I know I've been having that since 13 weeks because I remember mentioning it to my doctor. And, I mean, it's there. I don't think it's going to go away until I deliver him. I just hope it doesn't give me any issues during labor and delivery. Nothing. I mean, I put a heating pad on it and it really, like, it may help it a little bit, but it really doesn't do anything. Yeah. And I refuse to just take Tylenol because of it. I don't know, that may be kind of silly, but I just assume deal with it. I mean, I've dealt with it for so long, I don't want to pop a bunch of Tylenol because of it. So, yeah. There has been some mornings that I wake up and I'm in so much pain. My hips kill me. My legs are killing me. And one morning, I think it was like last week, I woke up and my hips hurt so bad. It felt like they were broken or dislocated or something. I mean, they hurt so bad. So I told my husband to flip the mattress. And since we've done that, or since he did that, I've actually been sleeping a little better. I mean, I still wake up throughout the night to go pee and stuff, but there's still some aches, but it's nothing like it was. Flipping the mattress really helped me sleep through the night and not have so much pain in my hips. So, and I do sleep on my sides. I flop from side to side, but I have pillows all around me. I stick a pillow between my legs. I put my stomach on a pillow. I tuck a pillow behind me. So it's getting real. Oh, let's see. I'm trying to think. Cravings, I really can't even begin to tell you what I've been craving. I still crave sweets. I did go through a corn dog phase where I ate a corn dog, or actually I ate two corn dogs for lunch for like a straight 2 weeks. And then we had a festival that have like those huge corn dogs. And I ate one of those and I just did not want a corn dog anymore after that. Until yesterday, I brought back the corn dogs. So, I've also been on like those toaster scrambles thing that you can stick in the toaster or the toaster oven for breakfast. I almost have to have one every single morning or my day is not even gonna go right. I have to have a toaster scramble and my orange juice. So I just eat whatever comes to mind. If there's something that I'm like, oh, I want this, I don't know, like, whatever. I've got to shift around. My legs are starting to fall asleep. Oh, let's see. I'm trying to think of what else that I can tell y'all. My last appointment, or maybe it was at my 18-week appointment when I did the scan, I was offered the, yeah, I think it was at my 18-week appointment. I was offered the genetics testing, you know, to test for Down syndrome and all of that, which I declined. I did not want that done, so we didn't do that. But with all the ultrasounds and things that I've had, there's been no concerns. He looks perfect. He looks so healthy that there's been no concerns with him. So we're going to keep praying that everything keeps going that way and it's all going to be good. So at my next appointment, which I think is December 23rd. Oh gosh. Sorry, y'all. Is my glucose screening test, which should be fun. Hopefully I pass that. I don't know if there's any signs or symptoms that could kind of tell you that you may have gestational diabetes. I don't know. But I haven't had any of that. So hopefully I pass that test. And he started at my last appointment, he started measuring my belly. So that was interesting. And they listened to him, to the baby with a Doppler. So I think his heart rate was 155 or something like that. But let's see. I didn't have to start wearing maternity clothes until 18 weeks. Like, I wore my regular pants, well, not my jeans, but like my work pants, for as long as I could. And when I hit 18 weeks, I said, I can't do it anymore. I can't. So 18 weeks was when I actually started wearing maternity pants. And it's so hard to find maternity clothes, at least in my area. Everywhere I've gone, they said I have to order online. And I go to Old Navy and they don't have a very big selection. We have a Motherhood Maternity, which is where I got the pants that I'm wearing and a few other pair. But man, I mean, it's so hard to find maternity clothes. But I'm going out of town next week on a conference with my job, which is in a bigger city. So I'm going to do some shopping while I'm gone, hopefully, and I can find some pants. But yeah, or some clothes, some stuff, some shirts and pants, but whatever. But I don't know, like, I told my doctor at my last appointment, I said, everything's been smooth sailing, knock on wood, so far, so I'm hoping the remainder of this pregnancy is just the same. So, yeah, let's see, I don't know if I've told y'all this, but I do have a part-time job that I've been working on the weekends at the hospital where I used to work full-time. And I went back in the spring because, you know, I found out that they were short-handed and it was before my cruise, and I figured, you know, I could use some extra cruise money, so why not? Well, I'm still doing that and it's killing me. It is absolutely killing me. So I put in my notice yesterday. I'm going to work until, I mean, I'm still going to be there a good month. I think February the 8th is my last weekend to be there, which I probably should have made it sooner, but I'm going to try to make it till then. And hey y'all, sorry. The FedEx people decided to come. So, I'm gonna go ahead and do a belly shot for y'all. And, just excuse my room. Okay, it's a mess. So, okay. There we go. See, like, the clothes. So, yeah. There is belly. And then on the front. So that is almost 6 months. So, or almost 24 weeks. Ugh. Okay, get myself repositioned here. I have no idea what I was just talking about. I'm sorry, they distracted me. So, anyway, pregnancy is going really well, and I hope to start making more videos for you guys. I want to do, and there's some other videos that I want to do that's not really pregnancy related or anything. They are actually kind of, I don't know if you'd call them beauty related. And let me just tell you, I am not a beauty, what do you call them, gurus or whatever. I am not. I am not a stylist. I am not a makeup artist. I am just your nerdy girl here, okay? But I really enjoy watching certain videos here on YouTube, one of which is called like an empties video. I don't know if you're familiar with that. But if you're not, basically what it is the person doing the video goes through their empties, their trash, basically. But it's not like trash. Say like it could be like this can of, what is this, Airwick 4-in-1 room spray, and it's empty, and they would give you their review about it, and if they would repurchase it. I like the videos. Look up some empties and you'll see what I'm talking about. I like them. And I also resubscribed to Ipsy, and I'm going to give Beauty Box 5 a try. So I want to do some unboxings, and I would like to include those items in my empties if I can use them. But you do them like once a month or whenever you get a nice amount of things to talk about. So mine, of course, would include more than just beauty products, you know, face care, hair, stuff like this, room sprays, candles, baby things when baby comes, you know, just whatever. But yeah, there's some videos that I would really, really like to do, but it's just doing them. But anyway, trying to think of if there's anything else to share with you all before I go. I don't know. My face is breaking out really bad. And I haven't done my eyebrows not once since I've been pregnant, and it's driving me crazy. Really, like, it's driving me nuts. But oh well. Alright, well, I guess I will leave it there, and hopefully I will see y'all soon. If not for a pregnancy update, maybe for an unboxing of the little subscriptions that I'm getting, so be on the lookout for those. Hopefully, I'm not going to promise, but I hope to start getting back in the swing of things, and then, I think I said my next appointment's December 23rd, so I'll come in and let y'all know about that because I'm doing my glucose screen test. So, all right, well, I will see y'all next time.